वेलकम बैक टू द कॉमर्स कोच. इन टुडेज वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू हैव वन ऑफ द टॉपिक फ्रॉम इनकम टैक्स एक्ट कॉल एग्रीकल्चरल इनकम. इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक फ्रॉम द पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ऑफ एग्जाम्स एंड फॉर योर नॉलेज ऑल्सो. सो लेट्स हैव दिस टॉपिक एंड हैव डिस्कशन ऑन इट. बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस topic, it is a disclaimer to you guys that these notes are prepared by the commerce coach. If these notes helped you, so please follow the commerce coach. Please share these notes to your friends and whosoever need these notes. So let's start the video. Before starting the lecture, we should know the meaning of agricultural income. So before having anything or discussing anything, we should discuss some of the points by which we can conduct that particular income will be included in agricultural income or not. So how can we identify a particular income to be agricultural or from other sources of income? Like we have five major heads, so in which will it come, agricultural income? So let's have discussion. Firstly, agricultural income comes in under section 21A. Income from, first income is income from letting out of land for the agricultural purpose. Suppose someone rented his land for someone and receiving rent on that, and the activity is incurring on that land is of agricultural. So will that rent a part of agriculture income or not? Let's take an example. If Mr. A has given his land to Mr. B and Mr. B is doing agricultural activity in its land, so and he gives him in return of land 200 kg of wheat. This is not a cash consideration. Will and the market value of this wheat is 10 per kg. So will this 2000 rupees 200 multiplied by 10 be included in agricultural income? So if we multiply with the market value of 200 kg with rupees 10, it will come 2000. So will this 2000 rupees is agricultural income for Mr. A, because Mr. A has rented his land to Mr. B and B is giving in return of non-cash consideration, means 2000 kgs of wheat. Will this consideration for A will come under agricultural income or not? So yes, this will come under agricultural income, but certain conditions will apply on that. The conditions are, the land should be situated in India, means whatever land is rented out to Mr. B should be in India. Second is let out for being used for agricultural purpose, and whatever land is given to the Mr. B, he should conduct agricultural produces or have agricultural produces. Here produces will come. What does agricultural produces means? Means basic plus subsequent operation should be there. What does basic and subsequent operation means? Basic operations means plugging of land, means to make the crop sprout out from the land. Whatever the process is being used for making one crop to be sprout out from the land, like plugging of land, sowing of seeds, planting and other similar operations on land. And what does subsequent operation means? Subsequent operations means after the crop sprout out from the land, whatever actions are doing, like digging the soil around the growth, some pesticides are being used कटिंग हार्वेस्टिंग दीज ऑल एक्टिविटीज कम्स अंडर सब्सिक्वेंट ऑपरेशन. सो बोथ द कंडीशंस बोथ द ऑपरेशन शुड बी कंडक्टेड इन एग्रीकल्चरल लैंड देन वी कैन कॉल इट एज एन एग्रीकल्चरल दैट लैंड हैज़ बीन यूज फॉर एग्रीकल्चरल पर्पसेज. सो आई होप दिस फर्स्ट मीनिंग ऑफ एग्रीकल्चरल लैंड यू आर गेटिंग. बट एज आई कंसिडर्ड हेयर 200 rupees 200 kg of wheat multiplied by 10 rupees. What is this 10 rupees? This 10 rupees is market value. So here also you can see that income can be in cash or kind. It can be in cash or in kind. But market value should be taken. And one more thing is interest on delayed payment. If Mr. B delayed on paying rent to Mr. A and given interest on that, so would that income also be included in agricultural income? Suppose let's take that example again. Mr. A given land to Mr. B for rent and Mr. B have to pay 2000 rupees to Mr. A, but he didn't pay, and on this conduct he has to pay 10% extra interest. Means 10% of 2000 is 200. So will this 200 also be considered as agricultural income? So no, this will not be considered as agricultural income. Delayed payment interest will not be considered as agricultural income. It will be conducted as other sources. So I hope this is clear to you. Now move into second explanation, income from agricultural operation. The section is 21A B. Income from agricultural operation means, now the basic meaning that you might be listening from a very beginning, that agricultural operation, income earned by any person from sale of crops which have been grown as agricultural operation. Which have been grown as agricultural operation, sale of crops. Very basic meaning we are understanding from a very beginning, that agricultural operation means sale of crops. But it is having a very wide meaning. So it is one of them. Now discuss what is agricultural operation. As we discussed in it earlier, basic plus subsequent operation. Whenever in any land is conducted any basic or subsequent operation and you are selling that crop, this will also come under agricultural income. And if you did some of the marketing operation on it for making good fit to sell in the market, so will that additional operation also included in agricultural income or not? Think of it. I am saying that, let's take an example. You have grown potato. You have grown potatoes and you are cleaning it from very technical operations, and it you packed it in a very attractive packets. So will this not attractive packets, you just cleaned it up for making it good to be sale. So will this income, because of this, it increased your income? As you can understand that one thing which is very dirty and the customer has to clean it up and you did for customers, so you will charge extra for that activity. So will that extra amount also be included in agricultural income? So yes, that extra amount also will be included in agricultural income, because you made this product fit to sell in the market. So whatever activities is done for making any good sale in the market and increases your income, that income will also be included in agricultural income. So here you can see marketing operation or marketing process, additional operations which make the product fit for sale in the market. Gain from this operation treated as agricultural income. Whatever you gain from that activity is also treated as agricultural income. So let's move to the third explanation for the agricultural income. Income from farm building. Section 21AC. Farm building. It is not a farmhouse. It is farm building. Means you have given your building, which is on agricultural land, to someone for storing the product. So will that income also be treated as agricultural income or not? So let's discuss. Following condition need to be fulfilled cumulatively. Means this cumulatively means you cannot skip any of the topic for having the conduct of agricultural income or for calculating agricultural income. So first is building within the agricultural field or vicinity. Means buildings should be near to the agricultural building or should be in agricultural field. Okay, the second condition is used for storing agricultural produce for agricultural implements or a residential dwelling. You have given or you are using that building for storing agricultural produce. Whatever you produced, you are using that building only for storing agricultural, and sometimes for residential dwelling unit. Why residential dwelling unit? Because whosoever caring for all the products or all the produces, for taking care of all that, one or two persons may live on that building, so it will be considered as residential dwelling unit, but the purpose should be for agricultural only. Land should be classified as an agricultural land. Third condition is land should be classified as agricultural land in government record. Means government record, it should be considered as, it should be classified as agricultural income. If not, then it should not be situated in urban area. Means it should be situated in rural area, you can say. Note, income shall be computed applying provision of house property. Whatever income you will calculate from this, it should be classified as house, it should be calculated as you are calculating the house property income. So that's all for this video. In next video, we will be computing some of the practical portions. We will conduct some practical portions of this video. So if you like this video, please share and subscribe this video and share this video to your friends. Stay tuned with The Commerce Coach. Thank you for watching.